Yo guys, good morning. Wait, why am I so dark? Good morning guys, I am about to have some driver's lessons and then after that I'm gonna be squatting. First, I'm gonna set some coffee. It's gonna be a rough morning. Boy, my hair, bruh. I went to bed with my hair like wet.
Bruh.
Trimix in the house. He said he's gonna skip leg day.
What leg day?
Bruh, he a bitch.
Leg day sucks. I just skated yesterday, man. My legs are on point, man.
Basically, he just a bitch. Time for the pre-workout, though. One scoop of energy. One scoop of nitric. I also have one banana pre-workout. Yesterday, I had a lot of food before I went to bed. So today is probably going to be a pretty fucking good pump. But I'm going to just have a banana. I didn't eat anything else today yet. I'll see you guys in the gym. When you walk my way, I feel a rush come over me. It's the things you say that makes a rush come over me. Got my belt, so there's no way I'm gonna be going for a PR today. I guess I'm just gonna go for volume. Let's see what I can do with 140 without a belt. That didn't feel that clean. I need a belt when I go this high in weight. I definitely need a belt. Sunburnt, guys. Having this weight on my back kinda hurts.
Feasting on our waste before they are erased. They strike back. Scrap attack. Scrap attack.
I'm nauseous, bro. I think it might be the nitric and the fact that I just did an awful lot of leg volume. Tomorrow I won't be able to walk. Anybody got a wheelchair for sale? Guys, that's my leg workout. I don't train calves. I mean, look at these shits, bro. Do I really need to train them? Bro, I don't need to train that shit, bro.
Joe.
Man, you know the drill. So, yeah, tuna and three eggs in the pan. Post-workout. And I'm gonna have some rice crackers with that. For the little carbs, you know what I mean? You see this meal, bro? This is the meal of the gods. It's just pretty good macros, and holy fuck, I just felt my legs sitting down. Tomorrow's gonna be fun. I love not being able to walk. Bro, I got acne showing up on my face, bro. This trend hitting thick. Honestly, bro, besides this leg day today, I didn't do much. I was mostly just at my computer and I did some work. I called with the team that I'm working on with some projects. And, you know, some of you guys might know I have some websites. And that's basically how I make my money. Called with the team, just did a little meditation. I don't know, I'm probably gonna cook a little bit because I have 2,000 calories left today. Granted, I lowered my calories to 2,600 or 2,595. Kept my protein at 230, up my fats to 75 and lowered my carbs to 250, something like that. And I still have 2,000 calories left today. So I'm probably going to cook a meal right now. I'm not hungry. Yesterday I ate 700 or 800 calories over my normal calorie limit, which was 2600. So I ate about 3200 calories yesterday, 3300. So I'm very satiated still. Today was a great leg session, actually felt really good. And I definitely focused on mind muscle connection more on these sets where I did 220 for reps. I did 220 for 10, 220 for 10. And then at the end, I did a burnout 220 at 13. The reason I did that is because I didn't have a belt and I wanted to make sure my form was good. Because I can't go high in weights without a belt. I tried doing 140 without a belt. It moved, form was pretty bad and I wasn't happy with it. So I decided to just stick with the lower weights, higher reps, more contracted muscle, and then burn out on the leg curl and then a hamstring curl. That's really what I need for a leg day though. Perhaps I could squeeze in some more glute work, maybe some calf work, but my calves are pretty insane. They're overdeveloped for sure. So, don't know, I'm pretty happy with my leg days. They're simple, three exercises, the base, and then two additional things. Could add some other things on top of that. Maybe a leg press to even burn out more, or go for some just high reps. I'm just looking at the thermometer here. It's 28 degrees in my living room. That's insane. I don't know how much Fahrenheit that is, but it's kind of hot. Today, I don't have much else to do. I was thinking of editing the deadlift vlog, which I haven't edited yet, and I don't even know what's in that video anymore because I recorded it like 3 days ago. I do all of this myself because I like doing it. Maybe later on I'll get an editor. But yeah, you gotta just like, I don't know. It's weird because I love doing this and I don't do it for the money either, because look at the views, bro. I make no money off this, but I spend a lot of time on these videos because I love doing it. And I don't have that with my main channel. It's the opposite, like the money motivates me and I have that channel to kind of like make me the money, so I don't have to make the money on this channel. I'm glad I'm starting this channel because now I'm actually doing something I really love and it keeps me going. But that's very important because I don't truly enjoy making gaming videos. I love working out because that's what I do all day. That's what I'm all about. I watch videos about working out. I don't watch gaming videos. I barely play games anymore. It's definitely a lifestyle change, but perhaps I should continue with my main channel. I just had that thought where I should just continue with the gaming channel, but kind of like cash cow it, still play the games and just run advertisements on it and still make good videos regardless if I like the game or not. And it's not like I dislike the game that I'm playing. I play Counter-Strike, if some of you don't know. Some of you might not even know I have 400,000 subscribers. But yeah, I want to make videos about Counter-Strike, but then also put like useful information in there and kind of transfer some of that audience over to this channel and inspire the lazy gaming youth to work out, because I've been there where you just gaming all day, doing nothing really productive, and working out kind of gave me a meaning in life to build and work on something that lasts a very long time. So I want to push that message on to other people, you know. It's the legacy, bro. What can I say, bro? It's the legacy. It's the fucking legacy. That's why I'm starting this channel. Why I'm doing this channel. Man, I've been talking up in front of a white wall for like 5 minutes, man. I should have picked a nicer spot. I could have sat here. That would have been a nicer spot. Hey, man, you know, talking in front of the plant. This is gonna be the largest part of the vlog. But yeah, leg day today was great. I fucking have trouble standing up, bro. I'll show you guys what I cook. But yeah, I'll include parts like these where I just talk, bro. I like doing that. I like telling you guys what's on my mind. Comment down below if you got anything on your mind you want to drop off. We're all here for each other. All right, this is the meal. Not my socks. I got 300 grams of steak. It's called bavette. I don't know what that actually is, but it's super fire. And then I got 300 grams of sweet potato fries with some mustard on it. This is a true, true meal of the gods. There's not any fat in here, maybe the mustard a little bit, maybe the bavette, a little bit. So maybe I'll have like a protein shake tonight with a little bit of fat in there. Usually peanut butter to get my fats in for the day. I up my fats a little bit, lower my carbs, so gonna be leaning out because of that, because the calories also went down a little bit. You know, less carbs, arguably less energy, less nitrogen, but leaner look. So let's see. And I'm not like at zero carbs, so I'm good. All right, guys, I just made a shake. There's two bananas in here, 25 grams of peanut butter, actually 35 grams of peanut butter, and then this Alpro protein, plant protein, 50 grams of protein per 1 liter. So that's pretty good. I put 300 milliliters of this in, and that makes this shake. Also put a lot of cinnamon in there because, you know, cinnamon got no calories in it, so that's fire.